Hello, everybody, and welcome to the final module of this course. So we have gone through a lot so far. We've gone through TikTok best practices, Instagram Reels best practices, and even just getting you into the mindset of how that kind of content creation works versus what maybe you have been used to for a long time. And just to understand that shift in audience behaviors and in just that kind of the way that people are using their devices, the way they're looking at social media and where it's all going. Because as I said from the very, very start, when TikTok came into play, people shrugged it off and thought it's just a phase. It's not going to last. But now people are realizing, okay, TikTok's not going anywhere. There's a huge usership. And we've seen that growth from module one, where I showed you that intense growth of TikTok and how Instagram has had to react to that and how they're continuously reacting to that. So this kind of way of consuming content, this short form, portrait, full screen, immersive content is really the way forward when it comes to thinking about your social media. So I'm sure that you may have taken this course because you know that, you know, I mean, you wouldn't have taken this course if you thought TikTok isn't going to last or Instagram Reels aren't going to last. You know now that it's something you need to add to your social media strategy. And you're not alone. So don't feel like you are behind. You're taking this course. Hopefully you've started to create some content or you're starting to get inspired with the type of content that you want to create. And all of that after today will hopefully give you the confidence to be able to go, I can do this. I can create content, because it's not just, these platforms are not just for a specific type of person, or as I said before, they're not just for young teenagers to create content. Everyone is a creator. So as a business owner, or even as a content creator, whatever your role is, whatever your goals are, you can use these platforms to generate an audience for yourself, to build brand loyalty, and in turn, generate sales and generate conversions. Because look, at the end of the day, as business owners, you're not going to say, oh, well, you know, I achieved my goal. I got, you know, hundreds of thousands of people looking at my content, but I got no sales. So you need to think about everything, right? You need to think about what everything leads to. And ultimately, as business owners, you want to make money. You want to get those conversions, those sales. So using these channels to, yes, attract and build your audiences, but to create content that people look to you as either a valuable source of information or somewhere that they want to support because you've built your brand personality and people want to support your business, or that you've created products or services that you're able to use these platforms to promote in a way that people understand what they are. People relate to them and you're almost selling to them without selling to them. And that is the beauty of content creation. That's when you are onto a winner. It's when you sell without actually selling. So today is the final day and I'm just going to actually hang on. Sorry. All right. So today, as I said, is the final module 4. So I'm going to be continuing with some content planning because now you should have a good grasp of how to actually create a video on TikTok and create a video using Instagram Reels. So now I want you to kind of take it that step further and just think about now actually planning those bits of content. Because if you've been using social media marketing for a while, you'll know that it's not necessarily that you're changing how it's not that you're necessarily changing the theme of your content or the content that you would normally post. You're just trying to find a way to create that content using these new platforms and maybe changing the narrative slightly so that it fits into this type of content creation. So if you normally post videos, and I always say this, and I have some clients that struggle with this a lot where they love to talk, so do I. And they're like, I have to condense everything I say into 30 seconds or 60 seconds. And it's tough. And I get it. But it is kind of the way that it's going, where you can create longer form content when you have built that audience, when you have that consistency, but you are missing out on like that, you know, that higher reach, the possibility of getting explored, that For You page, because you're expecting that people know who you are. And I think that you need to think about, you might have an audience right now that's loyal to you, which is fantastic, but you want to maybe expand, grow, scale. So you need to think, okay, I need to actually build from the ground up, build that awareness, then move them into consideration, and then that kind of action conversion phase. So using these platforms will really help you to engage and find those new audiences, but it's all about the content that you create to bring them along that journey so that they're not seeing you as just, you know, they keep just introducing their company, but I don't know anything about them. And this is the thing, you need to build that kind of brand loyalty, brand persona. So today I'm going to go into content planning that a little bit further. I'm also going to be showing you what your insights and analytics look on both Instagram Reels and on TikTok. And I'm assuming that a lot of you probably use Instagram right now for your business and you may not use TikTok. So I'm going to show you how you can use your Instagram insights to see what content is actually valued by your audiences. So that might help you then to actually plan ahead for your Reels and your TikTok content. I'll give you some more inspiration. I know a lot of people who are doing this module and this course are kind of small to medium businesses who just need that bit of inspiration. So I'll show you some content that, a bit lighthearted content that some business owners, small business owners have used. I'm also going to go through green screen, and yes, it has its own bullet point, because I feel like green screen content creation is a no-brainer when it comes to what type of content you should use or the style of content. And it's not that all of your content should be using green screen. It's just that it's a very, not easy, but it's a good way of being able to be the thought leader, show people what you mean, point to things, explain your website or maybe your USP or whatever you're talking about, your product, your service, in a little bit more detail with that kind of background to back you up. So it's like me right now, you can see my face, but you can also see the content that I'm actually showing you. And that green screen content is great for businesses that may struggle if you're not, if you don't want to add humor to your content, or maybe your business is in a specific industry that you can't be, you know, using too many of these trends, or you can't be overly humorous, or you have to be quite strict in terms of like your brand guidelines and the content that you create. And that's fine. And that's why green screen is useful, because a lot of B2B people might use this to inform, engage, and inspire, as opposed to maybe some trends that we have seen as well. So that's why I wanted to give green screen a place of its own, so I could show you how to do it, because it is a good way of just getting the ball rolling. And then I'm going to finish up with the future of content creation, because, you know, even from the last time that I recorded module 3, there's always a new update, right? So the first thing, before I even get into what I wanted to talk about today, is the fact that 90-second reels are incoming. So these are going to be a minute and a half of enabling you to speak or create content for that long. And I know that TikTok has the, you know, the 3-minute option to create that longer form content. And for some creators, they have longer, but it's still the core of it is still that short form content. And the shorter the reel is, it's not that the shorter it is, the better it performs, but the shorter the reel is, the more likely it is to, or the, you know, the TikTok and the reel, the shorter that they are, the more likely they are to maybe reach the explore page or reach the for you page or reach new audiences. So yes, 90-second reels are incoming, but you need to start using reels and get more comfortable with them, and then maybe see how a 90-second reel would work for you. And this is great. And my clients were delighted to hear that, because, you know, like that, they struggle to fit this much information into 60 seconds. So now obviously 90 seconds are coming, but I think you still need to own that short form space first. And when you conquer that, then everything else will follow. And 90-second reels, I feel, are more, they already have an awareness about who you are. And now you can maybe give them more information in your 90 seconds because you have built that audience for yourself. So like that, you know, I was talking about the future of content creation, And there's always going to be something new. And there's a few new features that I will speak about in today's module that, you know, it's just this constant, you need to keep an eye out for updates. You need to be aware because these updates are just, they are a constant thing. And it's just about adapting to them. But knowing the foundation, so the, you know, creation of a video, what makes good content, and, you know, that kind of, those principles won't change. So it's just about actually keeping up to date now with what's new, what features are new, and, you know, how you can adapt to that. But, you know, the actual creation of these videos, that process won't change because Instagram and TikTok understand that people know that now. People know how to press the record button and use these new features. So it's just that they're going to be adding to them and listen and adapt to other people's behaviors. So they are constantly listening. So if you feel like, oh, Instagram Reels, you know, they need to get this feature, or TikTok has this and Reels doesn't, and Reels has this and TikTok doesn't. So they are kind of constantly listening. So there may be a day that you wake up and the update that you wanted is there. So right now we have 90 second Reels incoming. We do have 60 second Reels in most accounts. So, but 90 seconds are incoming. So be prepared for that. So I want to start off today with talking a little bit about analytics and finding your valued content, because you might be like that, you know, now that you understand how to create videos, maybe you've created some videos yourself that you mightn't have published, but you feel a lot more confident and comfortable with how they work. And now it's time to start actually creating content. But like I said, in probably every module so far, it's really about the value that you create for people. It's about that relationship that you want to build, and you know that you're interrupting and disrupting somebody's experience on the apps because you are a business or you are a content creator, and you mightn't be a direct connection with the individual who's seeing your content, in that you're not a friend or a family member, but they might follow you for your insights, your information, your products, your style, your personality, whatever it is that sets you apart. So you need to figure out now, what actually do they value? What do my followers want, or what has worked for me in the past? Because it's not like you're reinventing the wheel. You're just looking back to see what people actually engage with, or what do people save, or what do people like from your content? And then channeling that into your kind of next step of content creation, because you, it's not that you're, like I said, you're not reinventing the wheel. You're not saying, oh, I need to come up with a new personality for my brand. You're just tapping into what worked before and you're adapting it now to this new form of content creation. So in terms of your insights, which I will get into in a little more detail in the next slide, but what you want to do is you want to know what people value. And if you already have an audience built up, and I'm not saying that you have to have thousands of followers at all, I'm just saying that you definitely have some customers. You have people who have already supported you, or you have followers who have always engaged with your content. And now, you know, when you are thinking about furthering your Reels, your TikTok, your content creation, and maybe you've been kind of tapping into things here and there, but you're still not sure where your strengths lie in terms of content creation for these platforms, you can start with potentially doing a poll. And fun fact, there's a new feature in Instagram where the polling options are going to have more than just two. So this might be something that you might want to tap into to see maybe what people want. What type of content do they want you to create? What do they want to see? So you could maybe create a poll where it's like, do you want me to create more of this, this, this? Or you could also have a question box that you put on your story. So you can go into your interactive stickers in stories and actually ask your followers what content would they like to see. Or maybe you want to create a question box that is, you know, I've been creating content for a while. Is there something that I've been creating that you want to see more of? So again, if you have an engaged following, then they'll want to have a say, you know, they'll want to let you know, because if you have your stories flooded with question boxes, you're not really going to get that input. But if you just are genuine and you're asking people that question, maybe like that, you're going on your camera and you're saying like, okay, I'm doing it. I'm doing more Reels. I'm doing more TikToks, right? I'm biting the bullet. but I need your help. So I want you to tell me what content that I've been creating that you want to see more of. What would you like to see? And then some people might say, you know, your personality, your humor, your information, your insights, your updates, whatever it is. And then that will give you confidence to know, okay, this is what my followers want to see. And this is what I feel comfortable with. And then finding the balance between the two, and you're golden. But really, you want to also look at your, you know, your insights. You want to look at, you know, what content have I created in the past that I can tap into again? So again, it's looking at, you know, what really has worked for you, and what content do people value? So again, you know, when you have valued content, you know that it will reach more people. You know that, you know, it gains more traction when it is more valued by the end user. So what I want you to do is go into your profile. So go to your actual profile page and then tap on the insights button. So it's on your main profile page. And when you go in there, you have the option here to, you see your main insights overview. And then depending on the content that you've shared in that kind of window of time, you might have to go back a little bit further. So in this period of time, I created more reels than actual standard feed posts. So they're a little bit further down. But when you tap into your insights, you can change this window so more content appears. So you'll see more posts, you'll see more reels. So this is a scrollable screen. And in there, you're going to tap into these little icons here. So these show you more information about your posts, your stories, and your reels. So we'll start with posts. So if you tap on this little icon here after your insights, and feel free to kind of move along with me and do this with me so that you feel more comfortable and confident doing it yourself. And also it's good to know that, okay, I'm in my profile, I've seen my insights button, I tapped on it, I didn't see my post because maybe I haven't been super active, or maybe I've just been creating, you know, stories or whatever it is. So you can change this window of time back further so that you get access then to these posts. So when you tap into this little icon here, it opens up this new tab. And in there, it's going to say, these are your top posts from, and then it will say based on reach and based on time. So you can change that. So if you want to look back maybe in the last year or the last 6 months, and you want to filter it down by a certain metric. Now, everybody's metrics for success are different. So some people, if you're maybe a content creator and you're working with brands all the time, they might be interested in your impressions and maybe your interactions. So those will be the ones that maybe you want to filter by. However, there is the saves button here. And this is the one, the actual saves one here. You can tap it and then it changes the format of your posts as to your top saved posts. So saves is one of the most valued metrics when it comes to Instagram. And this goes pretty much across the board for everything, because if somebody is actually saving your content, then it means that it's valuable to them. So yes, your saves might be much, much lower than your likes or your interactions or anything like that, but they do show you that they are valued. So I would always, always start with filtering your posts by saved, and then see what your top posts are by your saves. Then, you know, you can go into more things like profile visits. For me, this is another metric that is important, because it basically tells you that somebody saw your post in their feed, they tap into your profile. So this tells me again, okay, so I've created this content and people now want to go into my profile to look at more of my content. So that shows me that that's a valued piece of content as well. And you also have website taps. So if you don't see website taps, you just have to scroll up a little bit. Sometimes it's kind of hidden at the very, very bottom. And these are people that go to your website on your profile after seeing your content. So this, if you're a retailer, you might see that the top post for that might be something where you talk about new arrivals. Maybe you're talking about a special that you have on your website, and you'll see that those work quite well. If you run a lot of competitions, I tend not to include those, or not even include them, but I tend to ignore them, because obviously they're going to have a higher number of everything, because naturally a competition will perform better than a normal standard post. So try to ignore anything that has a competitive element or a winning element to it, and focus on the posts that you've created that you know people have found valuable. So for like that, for we'll say our profile visits, our saves, our reach, and the website tabs. Those are the main ones that I would look for. And obviously, if you are not an e-commerce business, if you're focused on basically just providing information, maybe you provide a service and your main goal is to get more inquiries via social media, so you're going to want to look at things like, again, up here, you know, did they have like a business address tap? Did they email you? Email button taps? And again, post interactions, profile visits, and saves. So trying to think about, you know, what do you actually want to get out of social media, and how are you filtering your posts? And then look at the posts that you created. So it will show you those posts. And then you're maybe going to see a bit of a theme coming out of that. Maybe you're going to see consistencies in the style, the type, the maybe what you spoke about, what content was included in it. And then write all that down and plan and go, okay, I see that everybody wants to know more about this part of my business. Or when I post about this, it absolutely takes off. So how can I channel that into my content creation for my Reels and my TikToks? So using that and just spending time with your insights and learning about what type of posts. Now you'll see here, there's also an any one. So this includes all posts. However, you can tap on that and you can filter it by carousel posts, by standard posts, and also by shopping posts. So there's a lot more options here if you do have a retail page with a shop attached to it. And when you do that, then it will show you another one here where it says like product taps and product tag taps, basically. So you can filter your posts here by every post, and then you can actually filter the any section here by shopping. So again, it will filter it just based on the posts that have been attached to your shop and your product tags. So you'll see then what type of posts people actually did engage with from that. So use your insights. Now, if you wanted to get more information about how your platform is performing, there's also the professional dashboard. You can see it up here on your actual profile. So it will say professional dashboard up here. So when you go into your profile, you'll be able to see this. So I'm going to just play this little video. So it's a screen recording of Instagram. And professional dashboard, not only does it show you your insights, but it also shows you a little section about how to improve your reels or all the updates to do with content creation. So it's a nice little resource to have. And I think that people don't tap into it as much, and it's there and it's free and it's constantly updated. So if you go into your professional dashboard, then you'll see it gives you your account insights and you can actually access them that way. You can also attach your, like if you, I'll actually just go back here a second. So you can see that you can add and sync WhatsApp for Business here. If you're not using WhatsApp for Business, I would highly recommend that, but that can be a whole other course in itself. But you can go into your ad tools, you can set up branded content tools. So this is if you are doing maybe collaborations, and then you can set up your Instagram shopping as well. So there's loads of tools that you can access in here, and it gives you your insights as well. But in here, it also says tips and resources. So you're able to actually tap into, you know, things like Reels, tips, algorithm, anything like that. So that's all included in your professional dashboard. And as I said, you can access your insights from there too. So there's loads that you can do with your professional dashboard, and it's right there and it's free and it gives you loads of information. Now, Reels insights. So we want to, when you start creating Reels content, or maybe you have created a little bit of Reels content, again, you want to look into your insights. Now, it doesn't provide as much metrics or as many metrics as your standard feed posts do, but it still gives you some insights. And insights have only really been added in the last kind of 6 months. And again, they will be fleshing them out. I have no doubt that they're going to have them. They're going to have more information that we can tap into eventually. But right now, it works the same way. So if you go into your insights and you tap on the latest reels that you've created, it will show you and break it down into the latest ones here again, based on timeline and based on different metrics. So as you can see, these are the metrics that you only really have the option to filter by right now. So you have comments, likes, saves, reach, plays, and reels interactions. Now, so saves is still in there, right? So I tend to look at things like plays, obviously reach. So it shows you how far your content has gone. So this will then filter by your top posts by plays and then saves. So saves here. And because I create a lot of content to do with tips and information around, you know, everything to do with social media and digital marketing. So my content sometimes can get saved. So you can see here the new add yours sticker story feature that was in the last few months. People played that, but they also saved that. So you can see here, you know, this is a tip video. This is another one, another one. They're basically all information that I've created for people and just, again, breaking it down for them in reels. So that's would be my USP, would be that kind of information breakdown, information sharing, and creating that information for people that it is savable for them, that they can go back and look at a tutorial, and it's quick, it's easy, and it's broken down in a way that they'll understand. So now sometimes you can see here, there's a couple of them that, you know, I don't have, we'll say, a particular cover on them, but these are just me playing around with some audios. And them at the time, those audios were trending. So sometimes there might be one or two little audios that I've done that are short audios that might go into the Explore page or the Reels tab. So that's what happened to a few of those as well. So again, you know, you are learning all of the time. And you can also get individual post insights as well. So hang on now. So I'm just going to go into my Instagram 1 second. And if I'd love if you did that with me and just tap on any post, because what you want to do when you're finished posting anything is that you want to actually see, excuse me, how far has that post gone? So I will be showing this in a little bit more detail later on. But if you go into view insights on a post, obviously it will show you the individual insights on a post anyway. So you have that option to go into individual posts. And sometimes you might want to go a bit further, right? So if you actually scroll up from that, you'll see more information about how many people your post actually reached and where they found you. So it will say from the home page, from the profile page, from the Explore page, or from other. So you're able to see, you know, even your followers and non-followers that have seen that particular post, that particular reel, and so on. So it will give you more information about where it actually went as well. So this is something that you might want to look back on to see, okay, this post did quite well. So why did it? Is it that most of my followers did, which would mean that it went into home? Home is basically like the main scroll part. Profile is when people see it after the fact. So if people go into your profile and then view the content, that's deemed as profile. Explore then is if you reach the Explore page. So that's new eyes on your content. And then other is people sharing it with other people. So it could be maybe that your post was shared in somebody's story. Maybe it's that it was shared privately via direct message. Whatever it is, it will give you that information on your post after the fact. So this is going to be useful for you when you see that you maybe your content has performed quite well and you want to break it down and see where did it end up? Why did it do so well? So that's quite good for measuring those individual posts as well. And then you have your TikTok analytics as well. And your TikTok analytics, because it's basically videos, it's essentially all videos, then it's all about video metrics, right? So it gives you things like, it does give you that overview. So when you go into your analytics and your videos, you can see that you can do analytics of your overview, your content, followers, and then life. So overview will give you that kind of general breakdown of here's the last 7 or 28 days. And here's, you know, your total video views in that amount of time and your followers and profile views and stuff like that. Right. So it gives you those kind of basic information pieces. It then shows you when you go into content, it then shows you the top videos at that time. So what were your trending videos at that time? What got the most views? And it breaks it down then into like the last 7 days, the last 28 days. And then you can also tap into the individual videos and it gives you things like Again, the interaction breakdown. So this looks kind of similar enough to Instagram when you scroll up, in terms of just showing you the, you know, the shares, the comments and stuff like that. And then it will show you the total playtime of your video entirety. So this means that, you know, these are the people who, or this is the amount of time that was spent watching your video. Like it, and sometimes it can be, a lot of it is a viral video. This particular video is a viral video. It hit nearly 300,000 plays. So it has that really big play time as well. And you can see the average watch time of that video as well. Now, the video was 9.2 seconds and the average watch time is 9.3. And for some videos, you'll probably see that if it is a video that's like 2 or 3 seconds in length, that you might have an average watch time of 6 to 8 seconds. And that means that it has replays. So this is what you want to aim for. And it will also show your traffic source types. So this obviously went viral, so it hit the For You page. So it will tell you that it just reached the For You page. And then it will tell you a little bit more about where it reached. Now, these analytics are from another profile that a lot of the videos on this profile went viral, because this particular page was actually creating series content. So it was part one, part two, part three. And because the first few videos of the series went viral, that account got more followers. So the more followers it got, it actually started to show that video then to more of its followers, if that makes sense. So when you have no followers and then your video goes viral, you will see here on the left hand side, this was the kind of initial video that the For You page, 99% of the traffic came from there. And then in the next one, because it started to be some will say following and follower content, you'll see that again, like the first video, it got 15.4 million views. So that went viral. And then in the next slide, you can see here that it got 400,000. So this was, we'll say, part two or part three. And again, you can see that the traffic source type changed there from the For You page to personal profile to following. So it's added more, which means that people went to visit the profile to watch more videos. So you could have a video that went viral that could continuously go viral while you're creating other pieces of content, which is great, because while you're doing that and people like that content, they are going to generally go to your profile and see more. So if they really enjoyed your video, you could have that potential of constantly having new eyes on your profile. So you do want to create content while you're going viral, because you're going to get those eyes on your content all of the time. So you can see here that there is that big jump from, we'll say, that 99% to now 67%, because you're starting to build a following and also people are visiting your profile. So again, you can see that those, like the views on these are quite high. And I'm not saying that, I'm never going to promise that you're going to go viral, and I never give tips about how to go viral. But if you do happen to have a video that starts performing quite well on TikTok, start creating content again. Keep going in the same niche, the same theme, the same style, if possible, because people liked it. So they're going to want to go back and they want to see more. And if they see that you're on your profile and you're creating content and you are consistent, and it is that type of content that you are creating, and it's similar to the one that maybe they've seen, that's gone viral, they follow you because they're going, okay, I really enjoyed that viral video. Then I went to their profile and I saw more pieces of information or similar style videos that I enjoyed. So I'm going to follow this person because that's the kind of content I like. And that's what happens. So more often than not, then you will obviously reach the For You page, but you'll more often than see your following actually seeing your content as well. So it's good that you know, this kind of series based content, this content that, you know, has that relatability, this consistency, it does work. So if one of your videos does go viral, then you have that opportunity to pick up on the other videos that you've created and are continuing to create. And as I said, probably in module one or maybe module two about TikTok, that your videos can start picking up traction long after they've been posted. And it's kind of similar with reels in a way, where you could have a reel that all of a sudden just starts picking up and starts gaining traction a couple of weeks after it's been posted. So, you know, there is value to that too, where a standard post that you do on Instagram or even on Facebook, it has a very short shelf life in terms of interactions and reach. So now we're going to move into a little bit more about content creation ideas and inspiration for you as well. So I've been kind of giving some tips about what you can do in terms of some content creation. So just to take it that a little bit further again. So when you are thinking about what content to shoot or what content to create, in your industry, as a business owner, you might have, you know, this kind of expert-led content that you want to create yourself, you know, that you're putting your own take on something, you're giving your point of view, or you're providing information in a way that you own your field. You know what you're talking about and you're doing it in your own way. So this kind of expert-led content in your niche, that is one of the highest valued pieces of content, because people might share and save your information and or your reels or your content. So if you're confident in front of the camera, great. If not, you can go back and you can use that kind of text to speech that I was talking about, or you can use text overlays if you don't feel comfortable talking to the camera, or you can use voiceover as well instead of speaking to camera too. Transitions and reveal videos. This is to kind of keep that retention, right? Because you get their attention, then you need to keep their attention. So transitions, reveals, you know, time-lapse content, before afters, these kind of things, you know, they work really, really well. So also you want to show your persona and your brand personality for relatability. And we know that from looking at TikTok, from looking at Reels, it is about how relatable you are as a brand and a business to the end user. And you don't need to be everyone to everyone. You just have to be someone to someone. So that's why finding your niche is important, and finding that kind of consistency of content so that you can keep that relatability with those audiences. And then also updates or news. So maybe this is updates to do with your business. It doesn't always have to be updates to do with your industry, but it could be updates to do with your business, your product, your services, or news about your staff, your team, you, your business, your product, your services. And again, you know, you and the team. So, you know, you might be in an industry that has quite a lot of competitors, and they might be creating content that you want to create similar content, but you want to know, okay, well, if I create this, what if my competitor does the same, or my competitor is doing something similar, but I feel like I could do it too? Then, you know, you can create that content, but just what sets you apart is you. What sets you apart is your team. You are your own person, so you can create content in your own style, in your own way, and that's what makes you uniquely you. So when people reach out, they're, you know, they want to work with you, or they want to use your products or your services because it's what you have done to set yourself apart. Navigating your website, maybe you're giving tutorials, maybe you're showcasing, you know, how to use your website, and I'll show you how to do that with green screen shortly. You can do some testimonials as well. Maybe you want to do the voiceover of testimonials. Maybe you want to do the text to speech testimonials as well. Something different so that it's not just a static post saying, I really enjoyed working with this person. Maybe you want to give it a bit more life. So you want to maybe take a Google review, type it out, or copy and paste it into a reel and use text to speech so that the actual narrator in Reels or TikTok is actually doing it for you. So that's kind of setting it apart. Packaging, or maybe taking orders and what that looks like as well. And I'll show you what some of that looks like in a minute. I have some examples, you know, tutorials again of how to use your product, how to use your website. When you're out and about, maybe you want, if you are a local business, a small business, maybe you want to get out and about, support some local businesses. Maybe you just want to show a little bit about a day in your life, or what's happening locally to you. And then that kind of series or parted content. So part one, part two, part three. So this series style content, as I showed you before, it can work quite well, and it shows that consistency. And it also keeps your content themed and structured. So that there may be some points in there that will relate to your business, and there might be some that won't. And within that, there's always a niche. So there's always a niche for what you want to do and who you want to talk to as well. So there is a hashtag called Small Business Check. And, you know, it is a thing where, like, people like to support the small businesses, and it's small businesses using this hashtag or even starting a video with Small Business Check. So some people might show packaging, they might show, you know, them getting orders, they might show a little bit more about themselves. And this is why people like to support small businesses, because they like to see where their money goes, you know, and the person that they're supporting versus the kind of bigger corporations as well. So here's just an example of that done in a TikTok style video that you can also use for Instagram Reels.
That shit crushes your spirit. It really does. It crushes your soul.
Example from this brand on TikTok that wanted to create videos to showcase that, you know, when a bigger brand is packing your orders, that it's, you know, this big box, it's just thrown in, that's it, there you go. Whereas for smaller businesses, that's what kind of sets small businesses apart, is the fact that it's more than likely the business owner that's putting it together, or their smaller team. There's a little thank you note. You know, there's that kind of personality and that personal touch that people like to see. And that's why people like to support those businesses, because they see the effort that goes into it. And I think that, you know, over lockdown, people saw a lot more of this. So there was a lot of smaller businesses like arts, crafts, those kind of businesses that were getting more traction and more sales, because they were able to tap into this kind of, you know, this is what sets us apart. You are supporting me, you know, you're supporting my family, my, you know, this is what I do, this is my passion. So that's what you're tapping into, as opposed to supporting these big corporations. So it's a good one to use. Again, another small business check. So this is somebody, you know, getting their orders and being like, oh my God, I'm so happy. So this is another one. And again, that was just a very short video, but it just shows that, you know, you get the order, you get excited, and then you make that extra effort. So again, it's just, you know, it's really about just show off your personality. And again, you know, maybe you want to tease out a new product as well. So see, even like this is just a before the video starts, but you can see like 2 months with baby, like finish time, like you can, like this is placed in a way that it shows that this is that person's lifestyle as well. So it's like, you know, I'm a mother, or I'm a father, or I'm, you know, I am a provider as well. And saying like these will be on Etsy soon, and actually giving, you know, building that up and giving people almost like that fear of missing out is like, it's coming soon, it might sell out quick. So this is just another way of doing that, using trending audios.
Sure, 30 views isn't a lot, but if 30 people walked through that door to come look and see what I was doing right now, I would be overwhelmed.
In other words, thanks for stopping by. Answer my question in the comments, please.
So again, this is kind of a mixture of using trending audio, but also that text to speech that I was talking about. And this is the, you know, none of these small businesses so far have shown their faces. So if that's something maybe that you are a little bit paranoid about, there's loads that you can do in terms of your hands, text to speech, trending audios. And that particular audio was trending for smaller businesses as well. But you see here again, the fact that they say answer the questions in the comments. So it's bringing them into the comments section. So anything that you can do to maybe spark conversation, because commentary is gold to help you go viral. Because yes, there is that shorter, you know, repetition replays that help, but commentary massively helps, because people like to look at comments on a video. While they're looking at comments on a video, that video is replaying and replaying and replaying. So TikTok and even Reels are seeing this as valued content. So this is another one. And of course, I'm going to support an Irish business here. So this is How's Your Head? They're on Instagram and on TikTok. And again, this person, his name is Mark. He's built his business on social media just using this type of content, where it shows a little bit more about his business and the person that you're supporting. So I think if you are a one man band or a one woman band in terms of your business, you'll probably relate to this a little bit. So I'll play it next. So So again, it's just showing that there are multiple faces to a business. And again, you know, everybody does everything. That one person does everything. So again, it's that finding your niche. It's finding that kind of showing your business in a way that people can get to know you and your brand personality as well. So that's someone actually showing their face. And another one here as well. So we know, you know, music obviously is quite big on this platform, but this DJ said, make the comment section a festival group chat. Now he is using green screen here as well, but you can see that I'm just going to press play on it. I don't think there's music to it. So if you open up the comment section, you'll see that people are group chat from a festival. So, you know, like, where you guys are on the stage, has anyone seen grandma? Like, it's just this kind of commentary, this banter, this fun, like this kind of sparking that commentary. And it's just saying, make the comment section a festival group chat. And that video went viral because there was so many comments on it. And, you know, people wanted to go in and see what are other people saying. And you can see even just the comments are getting loads of interactions too. So it's just something kind of unique and different that you can do. You also have a tick code, which is available in your settings in your profile. So maybe if you are doing any print material or you want to bring the offline online, you have a little section here that you can create a little code for yourself. And then maybe you want to, or maybe you want to put that in your orders. Maybe you want to put it on like that, any print material as well, for people to find you easily on TikTok. It can be scanned on TikTok using the camera. Another thing that you can do on Instagram Reels, yes, I am kind of going over and back to different ones because it's interesting to just look at best practices on both, and also what works on one will work on the other. But this is a kind of a recent update on Instagram as well, which is the collaboration content. And collaboration is a big thing right now when it comes to creator content. And you can tap into that as a business owner as well. So maybe you're working with influencers, maybe you're working with content creators, maybe you're working with other businesses as well that you want to support. So this is basically co-creating content where you can create or post a reel or an image or a video on Instagram. And actually it says that, you know, you can see it here that you created, and then it says, so it will say your profile and the other profile. So it's going to appear on your profile and their profile together as if you both posted it at the same time, but it shows on both of your platforms. So this is an interesting and new update that they really want to bring in collaboration on Instagram, because they're seeing that more and more people are into collaboration versus competition. So especially for things like content creators, if you're working with a content creator, influencer, then maybe you want to co-create or collaborate on a piece of content. Maybe it's a branded video that you don't just want to post on your page. You want it to appear on theirs as well, to get their audience to see it too. So it's the perfect kind of bridge to do that. But it's also good if you are teaming up with another business page and you want to maybe, you know, co-create this piece of content because they could have followers that you want and vice versa. So it's great to do that. How you do it is one of you has to be the author, which basically means that it's posted by one account, as in it's set up and posted by one account. But before it's published, you have to, it's in the tag section. So when you're about to publish something and you press on the tag section, the collaboration option comes up. So you can see invite collaborator here, as opposed to add tag. And then you search for a user. So you search for the business or you search for that influencer. And then you you see it here at the end before you press your tick to publish. So it's in the tag section. And like that, it appears then on both of your profiles and it will say both of you. So again, it's just an interesting new option, but this collaboration feature, it's going to be rolled out, I would say, across most platforms because they're seeing the value in it, right? So instead of using in page partnership with, maybe you're going to do a collaboration piece of content. So it appears on both and you both basically get the best of both worlds. So using green screen. So this is something that I've been talking about, I'd say, from the start, but it is a really good way of creating content and putting that content out there to maybe explain things a bit more or to push that kind of expert-led content as well, promote your website, get more views, whatever your goal is. So first of all, what I want you to do is record and capture content. So maybe you want to capture a screenshot or maybe you want to capture a video, and this is going to appear behind you. So this green screen content is going to appear behind you while you are talking in front of it. You can make yourself bigger or smaller, but you are explaining and then it's appearing behind you. So kind of think like a weatherman or a weatherwoman. This is kind of similar. You're talking about what's behind you and you're giving people this lovely visual of, you know, you're there, you're present, but also you've got this visual behind you that is explaining it in more detail, especially if you've got a bit of a fussy background, or maybe, you know, you can only record and you're on public transport, or you're in a place where the background just isn't on brand or it doesn't suit where you want, you can always use a green screen background to just drown out whatever's behind you. And so the focus is just on you. Or you can do it the other way, where the focus should be on what's behind you and you're explaining it in more detail. So take a screenshot or a screen recording of what you want first, right? So do that beforehand. So this is just me taking a quick screen recording of my website. Maybe I want to explain my services in more detail. So I'll tap into that. And as it's recording, I can do a voiceover and say, this is how you get in touch with me in order to, you know, talk about campaign planning or whatever it is that your goal is. So this is playing away behind me while I'm speaking in front of it, and I'm explaining my services and how to get in touch. And that's playing right behind me, but I need to have that content recorded first. So always screen record or screenshot, or have that content ready to go in your camera roll. So when you have that done and it's ready to go, maybe trim off the start and the end of it if it shows that you are doing, you know, the kind of screen recording to finish. So make sure that it's a clean record. Then I want you to open up Reels. So you open up Reels, and then before you start recording your content, tap on this little effects feature here. So the little button here, wherever you see the effects, whether it's here or on the right or left hand side, tap into that. Then what I want you to do is I want you to press this little magnifying button, so the search button, and I want you to tap on that. Now, even if you're just using any Reels or any effects, like, this is how you access them anyway, but I want you to tap on the search button. In there, I want you to type green screen. Now you can see there's multiple options here, but I want you to tap on this first one here. So this is the green screen by Instagram. You can see it's called by Instagram. Now there's loads of creators and loads of businesses that create their own filters and effects. You can do the same. But I usually trust whatever is created by Instagram, because it will be pretty much bug free and it'll probably have the best quality. So when you tap on green screen, it opens it up here. And then when you have that, you can always bookmark it. So there's a little save option here so that it's easier to access. But when you have it, the whole screen will go green. And then what you're going to do is you're going to press add media. So when you have that, you're going to, it's my little face. So you're going to upload the picture. So whether this is just a picture option, just because it was easier to show you this way. So this is me uploading a picture from a hike, and then that's going to be my background and I can appear in front of it. So whether you want to do a backdrop that's more scenic, maybe it's an office, maybe it's your website, maybe it's a screenshot of a product on your website, you want to talk about it that little bit more. So you can pinch then. So it shows you the option to kind of pinch, right? So you can actually start appearing in front of it, and then you can pinch yourself so that you are bigger or smaller in front of it. So you can make yourself smaller. If you are taking over a lot of the screen and you actually want to draw attention to what's behind you, you want to make yourself smaller. So you can pinch to zoom out and it'll actually make you smaller, so that you can move yourself around and appear wherever you want in the screen. And then you can start talking about what's behind you. So that's how I would be using the green screen in order to maybe showcase your website or your products, or explain how do you sign up for this. And then you're explaining it that way. And it's working away behind you the whole time, so you can be pointing to it and explaining it as it goes. So that's green screen. And it's a really, really useful one as well to use with media. There's also another option here called Backdrop by Instagram. And they've created some backgrounds for you that are high quality backgrounds that you can use and appear in front of if you wanted to. So there's like a coffee shop, there's more scenic ones, there's a boardroom. So this backdrop feature, so they see the value in green screen and they see a lot of people using it, because it allows you to basically create content from anywhere. So if you are in an awkward place where you don't want to maybe have the background, or maybe for a GDPR purposes or for privacy reasons, you don't want to show anyone in the background, this is a really good one. But a word of advice would be to at least try and stand in front of something that's plain, like a white wall or like something that's not overly fussy behind you, so that the green screen will pick you up as opposed to the features around you. So this is just kind of how it looks. You tap on it and then you can actually scroll through the slider. So it changes your location and then you can appear in front of it then. So it's very, very useful. And you can see there's like some, and then obviously you can go back then into adding media as well. So it's again, it's just that accessibility for content creation that they want to create for you. And it's something that maybe you want to test and try out without any kind of worry about what's behind you as well. So if you are a creator and you're listening to this, there is a creator fund on TikTok that you can sign up to. And it basically pays you for the views that you get on your video. So if you are seeing that you're starting to build up a bit of traction and you want to maybe be start making a bit of money from it, then you can sign up to the creator fund. And I have a little video here from Jess. She is a content creator on TikTok. And she actually explains how the how the creator fund works. So if you want to give it a little listen, even if you are a business page, but you create really good content on this platform, I would suggest using it because it might actually help you to just get that little bit of extra funds. Now, some people are saying that when I switch it on, I started to lose views. Same way with, you know, the creator content on Facebook as well, that sometimes they lose views when they switch it on. But look, this is how it works anyway, if you are intrigued.
So I've definitely gotten this question a lot about how much money I've made from my viral video or how much money I've made from the stitches. So I'm going to talk about it. Personally, I find money and finances and business really interesting. So I think this is really important to talk about. So as most people know, you need 10,000 followers to join the Creator Fund, which I was able to do January 1st, which was about 2 weeks after my video went viral. And throughout most of January, I made about $5 to $10 per day based on that video and the views I was getting. It's all based around views and nothing else. So I do not get paid for any of the stitches that are out there. But the most that I've made in a day is $47.98. And that was a day I had probably between 1 million and 2 million views. By the end of January, I was able to make $336.65, which is actually pretty good. The lowest I've made in a day is 77 cents. And that was more recently because my trend's actually dying. But in total, I've made $737.34, which is actually really good considering the amount of views you need to make money.
So that again just explains a little bit more about how the Creator Fund works if you are interested in maybe switching it on and seeing how you get on. There's also another feature in Instagram that they've started as well, which is the subscribers. So this basically, if you are a content creator or even a business that you want to maybe create another channel, it's kind of like Patreon, where you create exclusive content for people who sign up and subscribe. So this might be something that if you are selling courses, maybe you're providing more information, maybe you're creating a little hub for some of your followers, then you can actually set up, and they're kind of rolling it out right now, but you'll see that there is a little subscribe button. When you subscribe to somebody, then you have, you know, basically you get access to their stories and their videos that are just exclusive to subscribers, and you pay a monthly fee. So this is where they're at with it right now, but I know that they're going to start rolling reels into it. They'll probably start rolling like actual pieces of feed content into it as well in time. So it's just something to be mindful of if you're looking at another revenue stream and you want to create that content for them. So there is this constant battle between Instagram and TikTok where they're like, no, creators, come here. We have this opportunity for you. And then, you know, it's that kind of fight that they have. But listen, if you're a user and a content creator and you're seeing this, you're like, grand, keep fighting away and giving us more value. So that's just another new thing as well that's come up in the last couple of weeks. If you want to follow this account, it's not a massively well-known account, but I do actually quite like following her. So the at is Wave WYLD. And this lady actually lets you know what's trending. I may have mentioned her in the past, but I just have to say that, you know, she is quite good when it comes to new trend alert. And then she'll give you, you know, what's trending right now so that you can kind of get on it as quickly as you can. So to finish up, I'm going to talk just a little bit about the future of content creation before I finish up today. So you have done this module, and I really genuinely hope that you found value in it. And I do hope that it's something that maybe has given you confidence in just creating your first video or even just downloading TikTok or even just scrolling through reels and not being intimidated or confused, that now you are starting to understand that process. But because you're doing this course and because, you know, you are aware that things change all the time, it's something that you need to constantly be prepared for, right? Is this ever-changing social media world that we live in. But what to prepare for here as well is increased personalization. So even showing you the subscriber one, showing, you know, things like the creator fund, there is that loyalty that people have to certain creators and certain businesses. So when you personalize content to your audience and this kind of increased personalization or getting access to you as a business owner, access to you as a content creator, people like that, you know, there is this increased personalization that's been happening in the last few years, and it's something that's not going to change. So people want to know that, you know, you are creating content for them and that they almost feel like you can have this conversation with them. So things like subscribers, Patreons, all of that, they're only going to be getting stronger. Platform and interface changes, need I say more? Because we know it changes all of the time. Also creating content to adapt to screen size. So you've probably, you know, noticed in the last few years and even in general that people always like to have the newer devices and they're quite open to, even if their phone is a year or two old, they'd be like, oh no, I want to get the new phone. So you have to think about screen size as well. Right now we're working with kind of more narrow portrait style content and that's not going to change. However, maybe people's phone screens are going to become slightly wider, which means is your content going to stretch slightly? Are they going to become narrower, taller, smaller, whatever it is? You need to make sure that you are adapting your content to whatever screen size is the most used. But also we're moving into more accessible augmented reality and virtual reality. So again, right now, you mightn't really be thinking about that. But even thinking about things like filters, effects, how can you maybe create your own filters for, we'll say, the likes of Reels? That's something that, again, you know, would be another, that's another, as I said, course in itself. But it is becoming a lot more accessible for people in the social media world. So even things like virtual reality, you know, Facebook has Oculus glasses, or Meta, excuse me, has Oculus, which is basically a virtual reality headset. They have software, they have games, they have, you know, this kind of space in the metaverse. So they are working on creating a virtual reality social media world where, you know, now we're going to actually be interacting with each other's avatars. So the 3D avatars that have come into Facebook and Instagram, all of this is going to be, you know, bigger in the future, but it's just something to be thinking about right now. So I really, really hope that you enjoyed the course number one, that you put up my voice for four modules number two, and that you do have that confidence to now create content and you have a little bit more of a structure and a focus on that type of content creation. Feel free to connect with me on LinkedIn. There's my name. On Instagram, or like that, have a look at my website if you want. It's mgfd.ie. But I will say thank you so much again for taking part in this course. We genuinely really hope that you found value in it, and I hope to see you all again soon. Thanks very much.